Guru, can you tell me the history of Kalam and also the relationship between the Sultan of Kedah and Kalam?
It started when the year of 1136 AD. So, there's a group of come from Persia, 15 of them. They come to on this, that time we called Tanah Melayu. And then the country was named poised, state of behind the moon.
Mm-hmm. How you say in Malay?
Negeri Lindungan Bulan.
Okay, and today though this is Kedah, but at that time it had a different name.
Yeah. Then this the Arabic, they came here. Teach the martial art, the name of Kalam, to the Sultan. And then later the Sultan learned Islam Kalam, and it was that time the Sultan was a Hindu. So the Sultan convert to Islam. That's the first step where our country here, Indonesia now, become an Islam country. So we stay together with other religion. We respect other religion, because all religion is very good, you see, because we are getting close to each other because of the discipline of religion. Every religion wants people to be good. So this is started. Was the first who got this martial art, Silat Kalam, and later on he teach to the son. And at the time of Sultan Ahmad Tajuddin, Sultan Ahmad Tajuddin teach to the warrior. Hmm. Panglima to Ismail, what you call in Malay, Panglima is a warrior. So until that, Panglima to Ismail learn, and he teach to the another Panglima until at this time. The teacher teach me, and I become a teacher. Mm. So this is the history of Silat Kalam.
So about 900 years.
900 years ago.
From Kedah, the Sultan's family, sons,
until to the ordinary people. So I teach to Mr. Antonio. So this Mr. Antonio, we bring this martial art to all over the world to get all the people to unite, to stay and to respect each other, to live in harmony, and we are going to be learning a martial art of Silat Kalam. So Silat Kalam, we bring good to everybody.
Yeah, excellent.